Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class we'll be dealing with a very important topic related to economy, that is cashless economy. Now this topic is important from GS mains paper 3 point of view, plus this is also important for economics and public administration optional students. Now this is a very generalized topic, but in order to extract meaning from this topic, I will be dividing this topic into four parts. First of all, before we understand about the cashless economy and its benefit and the disparities existing in the usage of the cashless economy, we need to understand the important thing about cash economy. First of all, we need to understand the size of the cash economy. What is the size of the cash economy in India? And then we need to understand is about the comparative analysis. Comparative analysis. That is how much cash is being used in India and how much cash is used in the other countries. And then we also need to understand the cost of operating this cash economy. Nothing comes free in economy. Everything has a price tag attached with it. Koi bhi cheez free nahi aati hai economy mein. So the cost of the cash economy. Cash economy. And lastly, the disparity and the diversity. Disparity and the diversity in the usage of cashless systems. Now first of all, let us understand the cash economy. Now when it comes to India, the size of the cash economy is about 13% of the GDP. 13% of the GDP. Now this is the total size of the Indian economy. Total size of the usage of the cash in the Indian economy. This is in percentage, but when we quantify it in terms of rupees, it turns out to be about 15 lakh crore rupees. This is the tentative figure. So this is the amount that is present in terms of money. About 15 to 16 to 17 lakh crore rupees. So this is the total amount of the money that is present in the form of cash in the GDP, in the Indian GDP. But when it comes to the countries of South America, when it comes to the countries of North America, the cash to the GDP ratio is very less. The cash to the GDP, they have their total money existing in the form of cash is very less. It is just about 2 to 5%. In Brazil, it is just 3% of the GDP, that of the money that is existing in the form of cash. But in India, it is 13%. So this is on a very higher side. Now the government, it is coming out with a plan to reduce it to 6%. So by 3 or 4 years, it will be reduced to 6% of the GDP. So the cash is something that the government is hitting at, because cash is a type of resource that can be concealed. Cash is a type of resource that can be earned by wrong means. Cash is a type of a resource that can be laundered. Cash is the type of a resource on which taxes can be evaded and avoided. Cash is the type of a resource that cannot be exposed completely and that cannot be tracked completely. So there are some flaws in the cash thing. Now when it comes to the cost of maintaining this cash economy, now the people, when they trade in terms of cash, when they exchange the currency notes, it costs something. It costs to print the notes. It costs to transfer these notes to the people, to the banks. It costs to set up ATM machines. It costs to destroy old currency. It costs to mint coins. So this entire thing per year, it costs to Indian economy about rupees 17 to 25,000 crore. So this is the amount that has to be spent out of the consolidated fund of India. 17 se 25,000 crore rupaya cash economy ko maintain karne mein lagta hai. This is another logic that is given for introducing cashless economy. Government wants to reduce this expense, and this expense can be used for some other purpose, for running some employment generation projects or programs, or this can be used for alleviating the agriculture sector. This can be used for other disadvantaged sections. But it is not easy to transit to cashless economy, because there exists disparities, there exists diversities in the usage of this cashless system. The most important thing is about the diversity in the usage of cashless systems. Now, when it comes to the affluent sections of the society, this affluent section feels more comfortable using this cashless system. But this comfort is not there for the people who are poor. They find very difficult to spend money in a cashless manner. Cashless system is for the youth. The youth can spend money through this cashless system. But this cashless system is quite tough for the older generation. For the citizens who are above 60 years of age, they really find it difficult to operate in a cashless manner. Cashless system is more compatible with the urban spirit, and this is less compatible with the rural population. Rural population don't feel easy doing transactions through this cashless system. Now, when it comes to differentiating between cash and cashless, cash is more easy, more convenient, more quick, but it is not transparent. Cashless is transparent. It is not easy. It involves a level of ingenuity. It involves a level of intelligence. It involves a level of literacy. It involves a level of affluency. Now, if you are not that affluent to buy a mobile phone, in that case, you will not be able to use this cashless thing. So this cashless economy, it has a danger of creating another type of disparity in the Indian economy. So the transition will not be that easy. Now the government gives a logic that it has to spend around 17 to 25,000 crore rupees in operating this cash economy. But in the case of the cashless economy, again, you will be required to use internet. You will be required to use mobile gadgets. You will be required to use desktops. You will be required to use laptops. You will be required to charge and recharge your phones. Now, all these things will again involve the money usage. This will add to the expenses of the people. Now, when you do the transactions online, there's a kind of charge that is levied. But in the case of the cash transactions, this is not there. 10 rupay aap 1000 logon ko doge, uski value 10 rupay hi rahegi. But agar aap 10 rupay online transfer kar rahe ho, to uske charge transfer karne ka 1 rupaya lagega. अगर हजार बार वो 10 रुपए ट्रेवल होके किसी के पास चला गया, हर बार उसके ऊपर 1-1 रुपया लगता जाएगा, तो 10 रुपया एट द एंड ऑफ द डे 10,000 ट्रांजेक्शन के बाद उसकी वैल्यू बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ जाएगी। कैश में ऐसा नहीं है। एंड दिस इंटायर मिडल थिंग, द ऑपरेटिंग कॉस्ट विल बी अर्नड बाय द कंपनीज लाइक पेटीएम, इट विल बी अर्नड बाय द बैंक्स, इट विल बी अर्नड बाय द वेरियस एप्स दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज लॉन्चिंग। So it also has an operating cost. It is wrong to say that this don't has a cost. It is transparent. It can be tracked. It can curtail the black money thing. But it has its own negatives. So cash economy has its positives. It has its negatives. So it is a kind of a tough transition that India will be going through. So this is all for this class. Now the question that you can get on this: critically analyze the importance of cashless economy to India. What efforts should the government be taking in order to introduce this cashless economy? What are the different type of payment systems existing for promoting this cashless economy? These three questions are very, very important about this cashless thing. So this was all for the day. Baba, take care. Have a nice, nice day.